Hello and welcome back to the channel. So, another alphabet challenge letter. We're going to do D. Surprise! We're going to do doilies. So, I thought about doing dangles because I make jewelry too. But the whole challenge is having a timer. So, I'm going to have to grab a timer off of the interwebs because I left my phone in my bedroom. But there we go. Easy enough. Go to Google, type in the word timer, and then you set it for 30 minutes. There we go. I'm not gonna start it just yet. But anyway, I was gonna do dangles, but I don't think I can do 3 in 30 minutes. I'm not even real sure I can do 1 in 30 minutes. So I decided not to do that. Then I decided, then I thought about dictionary page. And we could do dictionary page. I actually think I have a Netherlands dictionary. Very handy. We can do that. But I already have the doilies. Well, the doilies kind of sit beside my desk anyway because I like them and I play with them a lot. So I figured if I'm going to do the challenge, I'm going to do things that like I use a lot. And if I make it, I'm not going to have this thing that I'm like, oh my gosh, what do I do with this now? But once I make them, I can actually use them in journals and such, is kind of my idea. I don't know if that's how it's supposed to be, but that's how I'm doing it. So I just have these three little doilies out. I'm not sure if I'm going to stay with these. I have others as well, but I might do those. Like, I have big, big ones. That's just a bag of miscellaneous grab bag. Wait, but I have like super big ones. I have a giant green one here. This is like a 6-inch. These are like 4 here. But I guess first we need to decide which ones we're going to use. I don't know. I'm just going to start the timer and then go from there, because if I don't start the timer, then I'm just going to sit here and try to decide for the next 30 minutes, and that's kind of defeats the whole purpose. So, I'm going to go ahead and start the timer. Y'all can't see me, but I'm clicking the button right now. Click. Okay. I don't know what it's going to sound like. I don't know if you're going to hear it, but I also have linen doilies, which are really cool. But I think I'm going to save those. I actually got these for a very specific purpose. And I think I'm going to save them. So I don't want to use those. I think I want to use this green one just because it's green and it's kind of a challenge. How big are my pictures? That might be fun. Could always resize them, but go with the linen ones. Where are you, linen ones? That's paper. There we go. That's paper. That's paper. Right there. Oh, that's more than one. Alright, let's see. What can I do? You know, oddly enough, I decorate doilies all the time, but now that I have the timer running, I'm just like, I don't know what to do. But normally, I just kind of stack them on top of each other. I don't know if I'm going to use that. I have, like, another bag of stuff. I think I set it down somewhere. Oh, I put it back away, is what I did with it. Shoe. This is just stuff out of my own my own digitals that I've printed out and some of them that I've cut out. Dunk. So let's dig around in there and see what we can find. Hold that. Ooh, you're pretty. You might be too big. I think you're too big. Kind of like these ladies. Let's use the ladies. Ooh, that's pretty. Ooh, you're pretty too. Ooh, you're pretty too. Oh, you're so pretty, I printed you twice. Let's go with that. I'm not sure if that'll go well on the green though. So let's try something different. All right. I wonder. Cause this one here is like really thin. I don't know. I'm trying to use the papers, but I don't think I'm going to, actually. I'm going to anchor this down real quick. And then I'm going to... Yeah, I just spent almost 5 minutes trying to decide if I was using paper or not. And I think the answer is not. I wonder if I can use paper for pee. That'd be funny. I was actually thinking about piano rolls. I don't know, that's a ways away though, so I think we have some time before that one is ready. Stretching this out, otherwise it'll, I just glued it to my table, mat, thingy, whatever. Alright, so I was trying to use these little images, but I don't think that's going to work. Ah ha ha, there we go. Alright, so there's that. I'm going to put these back. These are not working for me right now. Not for this project. So, throw those back in there. Let's look at the appliques. That's pretty. Ooh, green. Blue. Some wooden words. I got home, laugh, and love. Okay, I like that. Let's see. Do I want to color you? I might want to color you. As long as I don't have an avalanche over here, which is completely possible because this other side of my desk has not been organized. Only part of my desk has been organized. And unfortunately, it is not the part with my inks. Alright, let's see. I don't think any of those colors are going to cut it. Maybe that one. All right, so these are oxides. Stay. Oh, that's cool. You just have to be careful, because I mean it is wood, but it's not exactly the most thick wood ever. I like that. this pop so much more. All right. I'm gonna end up with this ink all over my fingers. Oh, and I just broke my love. No. And I was just saying, be careful. It's all right, I'm gonna put it back together. Thunk. See, this is why I like watching other people crafting, because then you get to see their uh-ohs. See? Back together. And you get to see their whoopsies and whoa-ohs. And how they fix it. Yeah, I have ink all over me now. Good job. Alright. I'm gonna put you right there. Hot glue or B6000? I think E6000 probably would have been better. Now, because it's broken, I can just go and do the other side. Back like so. Look, I have ink on my fingers. Oh, that's cool. Do it again. That's funny. Alright. Let me grab some wipes. So luckily, before all of this stuff happened with the whole toilet paper, baby wipe, debacle, like nothing ever being anywhere in stock, like I had gotten a case of these, so I'm very grateful for that. And I don't go through them too quick. I gotta get this ink off my fingers, otherwise it's gonna end up all over the doily and that'll be bad. Well, I guess not necessarily, because you can color the doily too. That'll be fun. Ooh, we should try. If you don't like it, you can always just try again. I think I cut my finger. Interesting. Alright, so there's this one. We're going to let this one sit for a little bit. And there we go. See? Pretty. Alright, let's put you over here. Let's put the ink away. And this is just a little ink box that I made out of a little wooden box. A little wooden crate box. Anyway, next doily. And these are great because you can actually use these on covers of journals and such, which I really like. I like this one better. Alright, let's do that. Let's glue you down. Commit. I think that's the hardest thing with creating things, is committing. At least for me it is. Which is funny because I never really have a plan for anything, but at the same time, I change my mind about 95,000 times while doing a project. Do y'all do that? It's like you start a project with one idea in mind, and then all of a sudden, towards the end of the project, you've created something that doesn't even resemble what you had in mind. Like, I do that a lot, actually. Like, I do that in life, though, too. So, I'll be searching online or something for ideas for dinner, and I'll find a recipe that looks good, and instead of following the recipe, I just kind of do my own thing. And by the end of it, the only thing that's similar is the fact that they both have chicken in it. That's about it. So, I mean, it's not just a crafty thing that I do that with. It's in life. Oh, I just pulled my speaker. I have hot glue all over the bottom of this thing. Because as I'm putting this down, it's touching my mat. See? I don't know if y'all can see that, but that's actually touching my paper because my mat is covered. So my mat's shiny, and with these lights, it'll just give you a big old huge glare. I used to use my mat, but then I got better lights, and now I have to cover my mat. And it's just a cutting mat, so if I cut through the paper and cut into the mat, it's fine. It's not going to hurt anything. I like this. This one's a laugh. Ooh, I have flowers. I forgot about these. These are little paper flowers. I like the yellow one. That's pretty. I like the pink one too. Alright. I might do something with that. So we're gonna put you up there. Another pink one like that. The yellow one. And then I can do that one. Like that. That's actually really cool. It's nice and springy. I like that. The laugh gets a little lost. So,
let's see. I've got some smaller ink pads over here.
Let's see what we got. We got blue, green. Green might be good. What's the bottom one? Red. Nope, don't want that. Let's try the green. Let's see if we can't get this all over ourselves. Oh, that stands out nicely. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to touch this with the baby wipe and see if I can't get some of that excess off so it doesn't end up on my fingers. Alright. Or the doily. Blunk. I don't know how loud that is for you guys. Oh, and it's wet, so it might actually change the coloration a little bit. Can y'all see that come through the baby wipe? That's so cool. That's cool. Hey, check it out. This is what happens when you play. You find different techniques to do things. That's so cool. Very, very cool. Alright, and then some of it is still going to stay in the wood because it's going to seep into the wood. So don't think that we're taking it all off because you can definitely still see it. See? You can definitely still see it. Alright, hold that. Okay, so we're going to put the laugh down first and then we're going to build our little paper flowers. See, I am using paper. I do want to use E6000 on this, though, because I'm not going to have enough time before the glue starts cooling off. So, that's one reason why E6000 is a good thing. And, I mean, you can use any glue here, just if it's good for wood, you can use it. Technically, you could use Elmer's glue if you really wanted to. I don't know how long it would stay put. I'm not saying that it wouldn't. I'm just saying I don't know. Alright. Now we're going to put this down here. And that's it. We're going to put this. This is just paper. I'm going to sink that into one of the holes in the doily. There we go. Okay. I'm going to put this one right there, and then this one. Alright, I think I'm going to take off a layer of this yellow. Yeah. Hiya. Hi. Hi. Come here. There we go. Yeah. Okay. So we're going to put this one down first. And paper to fabric, it's fine to use hot glue. I have found paper to paper is a little iffy. I don't know why. It's just like the glue reacts differently to it, I guess. It might be a texture thing, maybe. I don't know. So what have you guys been up to? How have you been since we last spoke? I know I'm not doing the videos every single day, but I am doing them more, which is good. Yay! And I still get to come and hang out with you guys. Let go. So that's cute. So that's the other one. Alright, so the last one we got a little under 10 minutes to do. And this one I had picked home. So we're going to go at the bottom here. I'm going to do... That's too small. Wrong box. Oof! Why don't I just put it away, silly? Oh! I'm sitting here trying to find a place to put my doily or my ephemera. Oh my gosh, find the words. The applique box. It wasn't. Oh, I know. We'll have to just fill it up right in the middle and then put the home underneath. I need another one in between here. There we go. And then I can put that like that. I got blue. That's cool. It's a little bit lighter. I think I'm going to take that off. Actually, I kind of like that. Okay, so we're going to put the little floweret thing away. I don't think we're going to use that. Put you back in there. Still in there.
Go.
What do you think? I actually like the color. That little bit of color has done a lot, I think. But then again, you guys know me. I like my color. Like, I like the muted colors and the earth tones and stuff like that. But I like color. Greens, blues, purples, reds. Black. That's not technically a color, but you know, we'll go with it. I'm running out of glue. Ooh, warm. I am so surprised I have any nails left whatsoever. I'm just sitting here looking down at my hand as I'm pressing that down. Excuse me. Alright. So, this one's going to be a little tricky because I want it to go down, but I want it to go, the home is going to go in between these two layers. So, I need to glue the top part down. There we go. And then this part, I'm just going to leave it as is, no coloration. Well, more than is already there from being wood. And then what do you do with these doilies, you may ask? What I do with them is I would use them as cover embellishments, like to go on covers of journals or scrapbooks or photo albums, anything like that. All right, we're just going to hold this for a minute or two. We have 4.5 minutes, so I think we did pretty well. I know I'm going to run into one of these challenges that's going to be like, I finish one in 30 minutes. Nevertheless, three. Alright, so that's what that looks like. So we did doilies for this particular challenge. So there's 4 minutes and 0 seconds left now. I'm going to go ahead and stop the timer. And grab my other doily. Oh, this is a little doily. Yes, yes. I'm just going to stick it on top. I use them pretty regularly, so I don't necessarily need them to go exactly where they're supposed to be yet. It's when I need to put them away is when I resort them. Like, because these, they have specific spots in my little basket. Like these guys. Putting them in the right basket. That is. Oi. Oi. Ah, go over there. Anyway. So while I have the doilies out and whatnot, I don't really mess with trying to put them away. Let's see. I think everything is out of your way here. Alright, where'd you go? There you are. Okay. So, we did 3 doilies. We did love. This looks like a close with my very painted, inked up fingers. My bad. And see, you can't even tell it was broken. You slip it back together and glue it down as if nothing happened. And then once this dries, you'll be able to touch it without the ink coming back up off your fingers or onto your fingers. And then we did this one. It's a nice springy laugh. The nice pretty colors. Pinks and yellows and greens. And then we did this one, which is home. Home is where the heart is. Anyway, I thought that was really fun, and I enjoyed that a lot. Let's see, what's next, E? Well, I guess we could just do ephemera for that. Elegant. Well, that's not really a thing, it's an adjective. Elastic, electric, no, I'm just thinking of words that start with E. Yeah, so if you guys know what to do for E, then leave that in the comments, and I will, see what I can do about doing E for you guys. Other than ephemera, I can't really think of anything off the top of my head. But maybe the next time that I do the video, I will, well, I definitely will have the idea, otherwise I wouldn't do it. Eco-printing? I don't do that, so I wouldn't know about that. Oh my gosh, I don't know. Y'all are going to have to help me out with that one. So anyway, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. And I do videos pretty regularly. Not every day, but on, you know, decently regular. And I will see you guys back later. So thank you guys so much for watching. Until next time. Bye, guys.